Hi everyone! After we discuss the editorial writing and the writing of even the opinion column, we will now proceed with the cartooning. Of course, we all know that every time you browse this newspaper, this cartooning will never be left behind. Why? Because it gives life to what you had written in the editorial article. But it is not always necessary that what you write in the editorial article will always be what you draw. Well, for this session, let's discover what this editorial cartooning all about, the elements, the principles, and even its function as to how it makes an article or even the whole newspaper a better paper. So when we talk about editorial cartoon, it is an illustration expressing opinion and interpretation. That's an important point because when you just look at the certain cartoon or any illustration, more likely it will be just about a message, but not necessarily that it is an opinion. Okay, there can be illustration where there's it interprets something, maybe a song, maybe a poetry, or maybe a story. But not all, or maybe I think only editorial, can express his or her opinion regarding a certain issue. So that's editorial cartooning. Another, it performs three functions, the same with the editorial article that we discussed last week, to inform, to influence, and most likely, it is to entertain. Because, as you see, if we just leave the editorial alone, maybe only 20% of the readers will really read it. But that percentage will get higher if you have the editorial cartoon with you. Like, they will be attracted with the drawing that you have there. So it is important. Lastly, the word cartoon is derived from two words, caricature and lampoon. Okay, so you take note of that, caricature and lampoon. This is where the editorial or the word cartoon came from. So what about this two? Caricature. Okay, when we talk about caricature, it is what? An exaggerated description. Generally by sketching. Kaya nga yung makikita nyo kadalasan sa mga editorial cartoon, it's just black and white. Diba? Bihira kayo makakita talaga ng as in drawing. It is more likely black and white and more of sketching. And those picture that you see, which like big heads, yan, yung mga malalaking heads, or kaya kung hindi malalaking heads, yung particular part ng isang tao na ine-emphasize or ine-exaggerate, ayan yung pinipinpoint sa isang editorial. Halimbawa, si Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, what feature of her face is always being highlighted? Like, pag nakita mo yung feature face na yon doon sa kanyang, sa drawing, alam mo si Gloria yon. What feature of her face? Okay, exactly, John Vincent. Yung nanalis mo. That's it, the mole in her face. Alam mo na agad. How about Pinoy? Our late president. Ano naman, paano natin malalaman na it's Pinoy?
Panot.
Okay, panot. Very good. Sa totoo naman talaga, he has no hair. Any other? Ano pa, yung what they call this, the eyeglass. Right? So you will know that it's Pinoy. How about the Duterte? Look at the picture here. The Duterte is here. Ano ine-emphasize dito? Anong picture ng face niya? Ni Juan?
Ilong po.
Okay, ilong. Kasi, ayun yung unique doon sa tao. Malalaman mo na siya yun. If he or she draws this certain feature and he or she is highlighting this feature. Okay, ayun yung caricature. Pinapalaki natin yung ulo and we are also highlighting the most known feature or most known part of that person. So that is caricature. It is to produce ludicrous effect. Okay, effect for a certain thing. Now, for lampoon, what about lampoon? Lampoon is a piece of malicious writing, a personal written satire that attacks and ridicules. It can also be described as a subtle attack presented humorously. Like, if you see it, if you don't know the story behind it, you will laugh. Like, it is a thing that is laughable. Just look at the picture. If I don't know the story, for example, I cannot read, I just look at it, it is humorous. But then, if you really took an in-depth analysis with the cartoon itself, you will say na, there's a message. This is a Chinese people, and this is some person who is just following what the Chinese person are talking about. You see, it is funny, yes, but there is an underlying message that is presented. Okay, so that is the two combined words. We have the caricature and we had the lampoon. Caricature is more on the drawing. Lampoon is more on the writing, satirical writing. Okay, so when we talk about satire, you are implying a message about a certain thing. So what are the characteristics of editorial? How can we say that this is an editorial? Okay, it expresses opinion and interpretation, like what we said a while ago, because not all cartoon gives opinion. Your cartoon, the thing that you will draw, should express the opinion or the stand in the newspaper. It is also called wordless editorial, meaning even though I will no longer be reading the editorial, I will know what it will be about. If only I need the details, that is the time that I have to read the editorial itself. It's written by the editor-in-chief. So, in editorial cartooning, the picture itself, the cartoon itself, already gives the message or the stand of the newspaper. Mm-hmm. Next, it may or may not be a complement of the editorial. So, you remember, we talked about last time or last week, the editorial article written by editor-in-chief wherein all of the board members agreed with what the editor-in-chief will write. So there is like a decision and the agreement. Now, what I want you to do is that what you write in your editorial article should reflect on your cartoon, okay, and the editorial cartoon. But sometimes it can be that it is not the case. Like, for example, your editorial is about, just an example, about dengue. Your cartoon can be about offline and online class, something like that. So it depends. But in our case, when we do the newspaper, I want you to make it like, here's your editorial article, and it is also an offshoot of your editorial cartoon. Okay? Then, it serves the function of the editorial and the other contents of the op-ed pages to present an opinion on the issue. Okay, so what I have said, it should complement, it should also support what you had written in the editorial. It is not the other way around. Mamaya, mangyari, pro kayo doon sa editorial article. Tapos bigla na lang, con pala kayo doon sa cartoon. So merong backlash. So it should not be the case. Okay, so those are the characteristics of editorial. Now, let's move on with the cartoon ideas. Actually, this discussion is quite short because what you have to practice now is how you will be drawing. And I will not be discussing to you how to draw. Okay, maybe. Let's leave it with your art appreciation subject back in first year, I think. So, yes. Now, I'll just give you a cartoon ideas like what should you draw in your editorial cartooning? So, it can be inspirational. Hindi naman palagi na kapag sinabing opinion, marami kasing gano'n na pag sinabing opinion, negative agad. You are already parang critiquing someone. It's not always like that. Your editorial can also be inspiring. Okay, like this one, Ilo Bantay Dagat and then the Illegal Fisher. It's like an inspiring message wherein those ilo yung mga taga Iloilo, yung mga nagbabantay doon, they caught illegal fishers. Okay, so it's like inspirational. Maybe the story of the fishermen in that place. Then, and satirical. Okay, satirical is what that's what we have said. It's like you are portraying a funny thing, pero may message behind that. Like for example, look at this. Children playing. Totoo naman na nag-children, nag-play yung mga children. Diba? Kasi tingnan nyo, yung nangyayari, they are all stuck with their iPods, with their cell phones, and it is a satire thing. Diba? Kasi totoo naman. It is funny somehow, but then it has an implying message. Parang irony. Parang ganun yung pinapakita. Correctional. When we talk about correctional, you wanted to correct something. You wanted to point a certain issue. Like this, class, this is chalk. This chalk is already part of my life because, so hindi natapos ni teacher. And then because it's also eating up your money po. Diba? Parang ganun. Parang kinokorrect mo na, sana those public teachers will already have their chalk allowance. Okay? This is the time like they are pushing to have, to get a higher rate for chalk. And then, yeah, nakalagay dyan, public school teachers. If you notice, guys, when you draw, less words sana. But then, if it can be helped, you can push it like putting a words in your editorial. But less, ha? Less words. Another is just a warning, like, this person, this lolo, does not want to get vaccinated. So, this what happened. Okay, like a cause and effect, giving a cause and effect. And it's like a warning to everyone. Okay, so that's it. Those are the four ideas you can have. The inspirational, it can be satirical, correctional, or warning. As long as it can, what? It can caught the attention of your readers. Now, let's move on with the most important part of editorial cartooning, which are the elements, okay? In drawing, in editorial cartooning, you have to make sure that you have this 5 or 6. First, symbolism. There's a symbol for everything. In our Philippine flag, what color is the symbol of peace or kapayapaan? We have this color blue. Katapangan, we have this color red. Like when you see this color, these are the symbols. Can you think of any other symbol? Like it is a known symbol. Kapag sa symbolism, it is a known symbol by everyone. Hindi lang ikaw yung nakakaalam or yung kaklase mo lang. Kailangan almost all people know that this is a symbol. Any other symbol that you know? Can you think of any? Yes, Joshua?
Cross.
Okay, cross. When we talk about cross, we are presenting what?
Usually Christianity.
Okay, very good. That's one. So when you see it's like Christianity, a church, something like that. Very good. Any other symbolism? Another is, for example, dove. And when you say dove, it's kapayapaan. Sally, you have answer? What is your answer?
Carabao.
Carabao, okay. Carabao talks about, ano naman yung pinapresent ni Carabao?
Kasi pagan, ma'am.
Okay, correct. Hardworking. Like, if there's a carabao, it can be about kasipagan. Pwede rin about magsasaka. Okay, about the farmers. Okay, so in drawing, in editorial cartooning, we have to use these symbols, the specific symbols for that, in order for you or for the readers to grasp what you are talking about. And then, stereotyping. When we talk about stereotyping, not in a negative way. It is like you're archetyping something. Like, what is is the usual drawing if you wanted to draw a rich person? What are the things you will draw for that drawing? Thank you, Vincent, for that drawing to make that person rich. Ano yung mga ilalagay mo? Sige nga. Let's ask Jeneline. If you're going to draw, for example, a girl, anong i-drawing mo? Anong ilalagay mo dun sa drawing na yun to make it look rich? Okay, accessories. Okay. That's correct. You put on accessories. Earrings, yung malalaking pearl na necklace, di ba? Ganun yung ilalagay mo. So, ayun yung stereotyping. How about if you wanted it to make, to look like a villain, masama? Anong dapat itsura kapag masama? Anong gagawin natin sa mukha? How about Mary Ann? Hindi ba si Mary Ann? Paano magmumukhang masama or evil or villain yung isang drawing? Mary Ann?
Yes, ma'am.
Sally. Ay, yan pala. Sige, mamaya na Sally, ha? Mary Gray, Mary Ann, how would you make your drawing look evil or villain?
May sungay, ma'am.
Okay, lalagyan ng sungay. Very good. Thank you. Sally?
The picture would be angry faces and he is fighting.
Okay, he is fighting. You can also use, thank you, Sally. You can also use like the eyebrow is like meeting. Yan, nakaganon yung eyebrow. So, those are examples. We are stereotyping. Though hindi naman lahat ay ganon. In cartooning, we are stereotyping, or maybe the best word is archetyping those things. Okay, for example, and for mother, they are always in bun and wearing an apron, something like that. Then, another is exaggeration. Of course, there should be a sense of exaggeration. Do not like be in your comfort zone. Okay, do not just stay in your comfort zone. You can try like exaggerating, like having a bigger head, bigger hands, something like that to highlight something. Pero wag lahat malaki ah. Dapat choose one feature you wanted to exaggerate in that place. Hello, Edemel. Miss Dubduban. Am I right? Miss Dubduban. Welcome. So, fourth is humor. This is not really necessary to put humor, but you can put humor in your editorial cartooning, like make it funny to look like. And then, analogy. When we say analogy, what are the related things that you can have in a certain cartoon? For example, if you wanted to portray a Filipino, a good analogy for that is a person, like a short person, combined with salakot. Ganon. Kung ano-ano yung mga related things. If you are portraying something about school, you have to make it look like everything is about school. Like there's a board, there's a chalk, there's a chair, something like that. Okay, so there's an analogy, a relationship of the things inside your editorial cartooning. And lastly, of course, is you cannot draw it, this five elements, without your technical skills. Of course, you have to make it look like there's a shadow, there is appropriate lining, okay? Ganun dapat. Hindi yung palagi lang tayo na puro tawag dito, stick. Okay? I don't know. I'm not sure if, unless may message na pinapresenting yung stick, then you stay with the stick. But if there's no, okay, if there's no, like, representation, therefore, you have to make your drawing look good. Okay? So those are the six elements. So these are some examples. Symbolism. One good symbolism is the salakot to make it look like it is a Filipino. Okay? Look at this message. You already know that we are talking about what? Sige nga, anyone? What's the message of this? What's the message of this editorial cartoon? If you look closely. Anyone? Okay. Prismaline, sige. Prismaline?
Try po ulit, no?
Sure.
I think this editorial cartoon means that despite poverty, Filipinos are still the third happiest in the world.
Okay, so that's it. Thank you, Prismaline. Actually, that's the story, the editorial cartooning about, like, why is Filipino still the third happiest people in the world, even though they look like this, they are poor. Look at the symbolism. How are we able, or for example, how did Prismaline able to decipher the message? Because the author or the illustrator of this uses elements. This is the symbolism, the salakot, knowing it's about Filipino. Stereotyping, we know that they are poor. Look at the dress, look at the clothes, look at the, it's like, yung, the place. Then, the analogy, it's about being poor, so the food, there's atuyo and the rice. And the technical skills, like, look at the shadows here and then the dot, like that. Maybe it's a flea or maybe flies, I don't know. But that person uses this kind of drawing and it is very clear to us the message that he or she is trying to portray. Okay? Then another power rate hike na naman. So in this, we can say exaggeration because a thunder or maybe a lightning cannot really hit you, but they make it exaggerated. Like this lightning is, we wanted to catch this person. Another, ito na naman, yung salakot. Alam nyo na naman na Pilipino yun kasi may salakot eh. And then humor. Kasi diba, parang they are portraying a funny line story. Like this, there's another run, okay, with a power rate hike. And then there's na naman. Okay, you can use words but make it minimal. Okay, and there's a symbol of what? Clouds, okay, a mad cloud saying that it is not a good thing. So those are some of the elements used in editorial cartooning. Again, we have this, remember, in drawing, symbolism, there should be stereotyping, exaggeration, humor, analogy, and technical skills. Then let's proceed. Let's have a short activity. So, I want you to identify the elements used and explain as to how it is used. Okay, I'll give you 10 minutes. Identify the elements like what particular object or drawing in here states it. And then tell me the elements and then what particular object represented that element. Okay, so your time starts now. I'll give you 10 minutes to do that. Go. Okay, I think we can start now. I'll be asking one by one to tell me one element and explanation, like how this element used in the drawing be portrayed. Let's start with Anna.
Yes, ma'am. I use, ma'am, the symbolism in the turtle, which represents the slow internet connection in the Philippines.
Okay, very good. So, the turtle, symbolism for slow. Okay, thank you, Anna. Then, Prismaline, how about you?
I chose the rope that is in the shoulder of the teacher. I think it represents the burden that was experienced by our teachers in this new normal education.
Okay, correct. Like, there, again, symbolism, like when we use rope, you're pulling something that is very heavy. So you use rope. You do not use yarn, you do not use a garter. They use rope there in the symbol, portraying that the person or the public figure is carrying a heavy burden. How about Jeneline? Yes. It's like the boy or the students are trapped with the system. The DepEd is pushing to have this education, the online class, and then but then as you see the boy is crying, meaning it struggles. There is also archetyping there wherein the boy is sad, so he is crying. How about Mary Grace?
Yung exaggeration po yung sa hand ng DepEd po.
Okay.
Na parang sila yung evil na pinaforce yung DL system na gusto nila.
Very good. That is exaggeration. Like making the hand big. It also represents power because the hand is big. You see, hand lang yung pinakita doon. Meaning, ganun siya ka-powerful. Hand lang, but it can make the system move. Like the turtle and the teachers move. Very good. How about Mary Ann?
Technical skills po for the stones na parang pabagsak na.
Mm-hmm.
Na parang hindi... Wala po siya sa classroom na eh. Yun po.
Okay, very good. Technical skills for the stone to make it look like it's already breaking. Correct. Joshua, how about you?
I actually noticed the exaggeration of the hand.
Mm-hmm.
More or less, the mind is close to whatever will gonna happen. And the turtle student and the teacher on the fine.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much, Joshua. The same with Mary Ann. There's a hand, but I also like what you said, like the teachers being a frontliner there. The first one who should be on the first or the initial part of whatever they wanted to go. Okay, so that's good. Lastly, Sally, what elements have you seen?
I think element that would be a satellite, which the message illustrates the birth of reinforcement with rent of the situation like.
Okay.
Just to survive the focus of the patient.
Okay. Thank you so much, Sally. You're quite choppy, but what I understood from what you had said is that there's a teacher is giving a consideration. That's why it's a burden. But at the same time, the students are struggling as to what they have to do because they are just trapped, right? So that's it. Thank you so much for your answers. So you remember, huh, these elements, whenever you draw, you should put these elements in order to show the opinion you wanted to talk about. I remember in my college years, what we did in our newspaper is about the Free Higher Education Act, wherein there is no more tuition fee being paid by us students, because back then during my time we have to pay 3,000 per semester, but then there's the Free Higher Education Act, you know, and you no longer need to pay anything. So what we did in our editorial is that it's like Mayor Gichelian, because that's the mayor in PL in Valenzuela, so Mayor Gichelian is like riding in this big metal thing. Yan yung big metal thing. Tapos ito yung wall. There's a wall. And then there in that wall, parang nakasulat doon yung tuition fee. Tapos ang nangyari, ang parang pinakita din sa editorial cartoon na yun, si Mayor Rex, yung mukha ni Mayor Rex na nakakaricature, tawag dito, tinamaan niya yung wall. Parang nabasag na yung wall. Meaning, wala nang education, wala nang free, wala nang tuition fee na babayarin yung mga students. Tapos yung bilog na yun, yung bilog na metal kung saan nakasakay si Mayor, ang nakasulat doon, Free Higher Education Act. So, ganun pinortray yung editorial. Okay, the same with you. Whenever you do something, it should portray your opinion and the stand of the newspaper. So, what are the suggestions for cartooning to make it better? First is that you should only focus in one topic. Do not dwell on so many things. Okay? Just one topic, focus on that. And in your case, you just focus on the editorial article written by the editor-in-chief. Then, should limit the use of the words and labels. As I have said, you can use words, okay? But limit it to the minimum amount. Third, should use universal symbols. This is what I'm talking about. You are archetyping, stereotyping, and making or having this symbolism that can be easily understood even by ordinary people. Okay, that they know that, oh, okay, this cartoon talks about blah, blah, blah. Should be, of course, original. You do not copy it from anyone, from any newspaper. It should be yours alone. And lastly, should not defame nor expose a person or object to hatred, ridicule, or contempt. You see, whenever they wanted to criticize a politician, okay, a certain politician about being corrupt, though it is not proven yet, they do not use the actual face of the person. What they do is that they use animals. And the most famous animal for corrupt, what animal do they use for corrupt people?
Crocodile po.
Very good, Anna. So it's crocodile. So they use the crocodile. Because even though you're giving your stand, even though you're free to give whatever you wanted to say, still we have to know the meaning of freedom of expression. We should not defame or expose that person, or maybe ridicule that person, especially if it's not proven. Okay? Freedom of speech is okay as long as you are not, okay, ridiculing, defaming, or exposing contempt or hatred towards that person. That's why you use symbolisms or maybe certain thing to present lang, but not really to expose. Okay? So, what are the tips for cartooning? Other tips? You have to take a side. You have to tell us, are you for or against this issue? For example, academic freeze is the topic. Are you pro or against this? Then, use facial expressions and emotions. So, whenever you create, yun nga, pag villain, kailangan, di ba, yung eyebrow, nagtatama. If it's happy, kailangan mataas ng konti yung eyebrow. Tapos, syempre, nakasmile. You can use yung mga teeth, nakikita, to see that it is the expression being used. And then, you use universal symbols again and again. And do not clutter your cartoon with unnecessary details. Mamaya naman, nasobrahan masyado yung symbolism. Okay? Baka super dami ng symbolism, hindi na magets ni reader. Ano bang gusto sabihin nito? Ba't kung ano-ano na yung nakikita ko? Diba? Yung sakto lang. Kaya ang sabi, focus on only one topic. Okay, you have to focus on one topic. And then, when you focus on that topic, hindi na masyadong maraming kung ano-ano pa yung makikita doon sa cartoon. Yung necessary lang. Halimbawa, a while ago, yung online class nga, where the child, yung parang nahihirapan siya, di ba? Pinakita nila yon, hindi na sila gumamit ng ulap na may kulog. Although yung ulap na may kulog, nagpapakita yun ng sadness or maybe hindi magandang nangyayari, hindi na nila nilagyan ng ulap na may kulog. Kasi, why? They already express it with the child crying. Okay, the unnecessary details should be removed. Kumari, classroom. Kailangan ba super detailed na talagang yung mga upuan nandun? Kailangan ba may yung buong blackboard kita? So, syempre, kapag unnecessary ito, pag hindi naman kailangan at hindi naman siya makaka-apekto doon sa message na ipoportray mo, you have to leave it out. Okay? So, those are some. Another, you use shading. So, shading, ito tayo, ano, kanya-kanya tayo nito. Paano tayo matututo mag-shading? If you already have an idea how to do it, then you do so. But not, if you do not have an idea yet, maybe you can watch YouTube tutorial. Maybe you can ask someone how to do it. Okay? To make it more convincing and real. Okay? Para siyang naka-3D. Draw your cartoons in a landscape. Not portrait. It should be landscape. Okay? Why landscape? Because it gives you more space. You are less limited if you draw it in landscape. And then you have your own style. You do not need to really copy or make it look like it's the same with the other newspaper. You can, we all have different skills in drawing. And you can make your own, like how your person or how the people in the editorial cartoon looks like. And then, lastly is to read. You remember, the editorial cartoonist is not just an artist. You are also a journalist. You remember, editorial cartooning is like a wordless opinion. Okay, it's a wordless opinion wherein you just present the picture and it's good to go. It already gives the stand of the newspaper. So you have to read even the details that you put there. You have to make sure that you have a basis as to why you put that kind of thing or object in your drawing. Okay? So another thing, an additional information, especially in editorial writing, opinion writing, you have to know that you are writing as part of the campus. Okay, you are writing as part of the campus. You are in a campus, right? So, most probably, what you should write should be like in partnership with the campus, which is PCCM. Okay? So, as much as possible, whenever we write a campus newspaper, this is also just what I have learned from my teachers, from my professors, that you can express like your contempt or maybe your hatred, like you can just have it right, towards a school, like the thing about the school. But if you look closely about it, if that newspaper would be published, who will be ruined regarding this thing, right? So as much as possible, you have to think that you are in partner, right? You are in partner with the school. And even though you wanted to give, the things to improve, you can write that. Okay, you can write the things to improve in a school. It may be you have to be a bit, what do you call that, considerate in writing these things. Okay, so that is just an additional thing. Whenever we have or we write in a campus journal, especially the editorial and what do you call this, opinion and editorial cartooning. Okay? Kasi parang dati ng college, parang, can we write things about parang, yung parang mga dark side, yung mga ganun, yung mga nalalaman namin. But then, sabi nga parang, do you have a basis? May basis ka ba regarding doon? Do you have parang, may documents ka ba regarding doon? Yung mga ganun bagay. You remember, kapag ipinag-aralan natin, every time that you write an editorial, there should be a fact-checking. Okay? So, that's it for the cartooning and the editorial thing. So, lastly, these are the thoughts for the week. If a newspaper were a living thing, as I think it is, its news content may be the lifeblood. Okay? So, ayun na yung blood natin. The front page may be the face, but the editorial, this is the soul. You see? Meaning, ito talaga yung puso. Ito yung kaloob-looban mo. Because these are your editorial. Oo, nabubuhay tayo with the news. But the soul, yung purpose natin, will be found in the editorial itself. When the editorials are flabby, complacent, or irresponsible, then the newspaper has lost its soul and also its character. Because it reveals who you are, it reveals the personality of the board members, and especially the editor-in-chief. So that is from John Oakes from New York Times. So it is very important that we write our editorial beautifully, well thought, and of course, brief. Okay, so for the week 12 activity, this will be the final part. Do you have any questions regarding editorial cartooning? Are we clear about this topic? Good morning. Okay. Okay na tayo. So let's proceed. So in your week 11, your activities. Okay, thank you, Ms. Malene. So for your week 11, your activity sheet will be about either editorial article or editorial column, like opinion column. For your week 12, I wanted to see how you draw in your editorial cartooning. Actually, I was thinking nga na, siguro isa na lang per group yung pag-drawingin ko. Pero naisip ko na hindi gusto ko sila makita lahat mag-draw. Tsaka ano ilalagay ko sa week 11, di ba? Parang kapag nag-drawing yung isa sa group nyo, lahat na grades nyo, parang anggara naman nun. So I want you to see, to make an effort about this. So it is 50 points. The first part is that you have to read first the editorial article written by your editor-in-chief. Okay, you have to read that, and based from that, you will create an editorial cartoon. Okay, so that will be 30 points. So, okay. Hindi naman sana pinapressure ko yung editor-in-chief, pero dapat talaga ginagawa niya. Parang gano'n. Kasi hindi magagawa yung editorial cartoon. And then, for the part 2, from what you have drawn, from the editorial cartoon, you have to, what? Indicate the elements that you use in the cartoon with short explanation. Okay? So, just what you did a while ago, I presented you a drawing and then you pinpoint the elements and then the explanation behind that element. So that will be the total of 50 points. So this is just an example, a sample work. For example, the title of your editorial is Graduation, a Mask. Ganyan, ayan yung editorial article. Now, this is the cartoon that the one created, the illustrator created. Now, what are the elements you see? Humor, the girl in the picture has a disgust look, and then symbolism, the toga cup to represent graduation. Okay, as simple as that. It's the part 2 is easy because you just need to identify the elements, but the part 1, you really have to draw an editorial cartoon regarding the written editorial article by the editor-in-chief. Of course, syempre, dapat alam mo rin yun. Kasi you are part of the meeting kung bakit ayan yung nasulat ni editor-in-chief. Okay po. So, how will I grade you? First is the message. I was able to identify the message by just merely looking at that. And then, second is your presentation, the creativity. Okay? Yun nga, mga technical skills. Is it neat? Clean? Is it creative? Though the color is not necessary, but of course, even though you use just a pencil, we can see that it's like, di ba may diin at gaan ng pagsusulat kahit pencil yon. So it also portrays color. So content. So it gives us the understanding of the issue. I was able to know if you are a pro or a con, or maybe if you want to commend or to criticize something. Okay, so those are the 3 things that I will look for in your editorial cartoon. Now, another question, is it okay if it's just a drawing? Yes. Is it okay if it's a digitally drawn? Yes. Okay, so as long as you will draw. Okay, any more question about the activity 12? Clarifications? Okay, wala na. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, I think okay na tayo. So, thank you so much, English 3A, for attending this week's class. And I appreciate your presence here. Okay, so shall you Sally, Mary Grace, Mary Ann, Jen, Chris Melaine, Anna, and Joshua. Thank you so much for attending.